Hello, I'm back with another We Are You Now video. Now, before I begin, I'm going to say that this video is not for the faint of heart, since this involves a topic, sort of involves the topic of abuse in the beginning. Also, the age restriction is though the same, 14 and over. If you are 14 and under, please leave. I know I keep saying it. I know I'll sound like a broken record, but I already know people don't listen. Hopefully, if I say it enough, people will listen. But anyway, we're here to talk about, oh yeah, and don't go harassing the creators. Also, we're here to talk about George Not Found, or just George, or Goggy. Anyway, so basically the major controversy he found himself in was actually fairly recently in 2023, where a YouTuber slash Twitch streamer, Katie Bugs, who's r around my age, a little younger, 2 years younger than me, she accused George of basically assaulting her, or groping her technically. He would end up debunking her claims. He would end up debunking her claims in multiple videos. Unfortunately, he would make a few errors. She would make even more by changing her story, and her story fell apart, and now people are mad at her. However, how's this re affected George's reputation? I can't imagine well, but that's why we're here with this video. If you do want a better in-depth summary about George's controversy, I made a video on it, and I'm gonna leave it in, a link to it in the description. An internet anarchist has also made a video on it, which is way better than mine, I'm gonna be dead honest. So I'm gonna leave his link in the description as well. Anyhow, we are here with Goggy, aka George, not found. I'm in a weird mood today, people, so just grin and bear with me. We've got about 10.1 million subscribers, and he has made posted 50 videos. Wow, he's got more subscribers than I do, and he's got less videos than I do. So his description reads, "Hi, I'm George. Business email. I'm not going to show it to you. I'd rather not. I'd rather not. If you want to see it for yourself, go to his channel, but I'm not going to show." Then you can see he's got a merch plug, Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, Twitch, and Snapchat. Huh. Got a Snapchat. Should follow him. Okay, I'll deal with that after the video. Anyway, so we're going to take a look at his most recent video, and no surprise, after what has happened, it seems like he's taken a step back from the internet. His most recent video going back to 5 months ago. So it has gotten 4.2 million views, and all of his videos have done very nicely. 3.9 million views, 15 million views, 10 million views, 8.7 million views, 6.3 million views, 11 million views. They are doing very well. They did very well. However, because of what's happened, George suffered. Sorry, I'm thinking of young Sheldon right now. I'm dumb. So sorry if I say Georgie or whatever the hell. But anyway, his most popular video is maybe from 3 years ago, which 48 million views. Obviously, technically, he has fallen off like many other YouTubers, but that is because of what I would now call colloquially as the post-COVID effect, which basically means YouTubers are losing views because less people are watching them, because less people need to be entertained by them. He doesn't really have any shorts, or I don't think he's, I don't know if he has a shorts channel, but he doesn't have anything on his main content of streams, but he does have playlists, and he also does have a community. Sorry, I'm doing this in a reflective way. So he also does have a community. He posted 2 years ago. Lovely. I'm gonna see if he has any secondary channel that I could check out. So he's got streams. He's got a streams channel. No, I don't know. What? So he does have a streams channel. Got about 1.15 million subscribers, and so this is where he posts his streams and videos, and this is where he posted his response on the whole Katie Bug situation. as you can see, it didn't rack up as many views as many would hope. But then again, this is a smaller channel to his mainstream. Then he's also got an extras channel where it doesn't seem like much is going on. But honestly, that's all I have to say about George. Now, honestly, you already know what I think about George. I think he's totally... While I do think he was an idiot for flirting with someone who was drunk, I don't think he's completely the one at fault here. The only real fault he made was actually afterward, where he basically submitted to something that didn't exist. Do I think George Nofound's reputation can take a recovery? If he takes his hiatus, I'm 100% sure this will blow over, and I'm pretty sure it might go back to being the same. But then again, Minecraft YouTubers, especially the Dream SMP YouTubers, are taking a hit after the whole George Nofound, Wilbersoot and Jikishi situations, and even Dream's faced allegations. Now, I don't think things are going to return to normal 100%, so disregard my previous statement, but I do think there will be a new relative normal for these guys. And I'm pretty sure they'll do just fine. But anyway, please do like, please subscribe. My goal is to get 200 subscribers by the 9th of November, which is my sister's birthday. And also, feel free to type happy birthday in the comment section, because as I'm filming this video, it's my birthday, my 20th birthday. So yeah, have a nice day, everybody. Peace.